EXT New York City Courthouse Day. Angle: a woman standing in front of a cameraman and a crowd standing right behind the woman and the cameraman. Camera: though the camera's point of view. Hello America, Terror Perry here. With current events escalating, the unthinkable has finally happened. Michael Walsh, the CEO of Dark Hero Incorporated, is being sued by a group of people who will come up on top. Will this team up strategy? Will they succeed in defeating Dark Hero Incorporated in court where everyone else had failed? Stay tuned to find out. Cut to INT New York Courtroom Day. The lawsuit begins. Judge Wallace to Michael. Michael Walsh, your company stands accused of homicide, putting a man into a coma and driving three women temporarily insane. How do you plead? Michael, not guilty. Charlie, I will admit that the products made by Dark Hero Incorporated may have led humanity to this glorious future that we now live in, but that corporation is more trouble than they're worth, and with that said, I will call my first witness to the stand. Angulum Edna. Charlie, voiceover Edna Noonan. Judge Wallace, okay, let's bring out the Revelation 9000. Judge Wallace presses a button underneath the bench. The Revelation 9000 is brought into the courtroom. While angling on a metal part of the floor with a circle on it where a jury box would be, that circle opens up and a metal chair attached to a machine with the helmet on it rises out of it. Angle on north wall, the Revelation 9000 TV screen descends from inside the ceiling. Judge Wallace, Miss Noonan, please have a set in the Revelation 9000. Edna, okay. Eva gets up counsel tables and sits down in the chair in the Revelation 9000. Charlie, Your Honor, I know that the defendant is rich, but I don't think that the Revelation 9000 is necessary. Judge Wallace, nonsense. Dark Hero Incorporated has made a lot of products that has made our world a better place. A courtroom bailiff places the Revelation 9000's helmet onto Edna's head and locks it. Angle on the Revelation 9000 quote S massive TV screen. Judge Wallace, voice over, and if Michael Walsh is guilty of what that group you're representing is accusing him of, then the Revelation 9000 is very necessary. Cut to INT New York Massacre Boardroom Day. Edna walks into the boardroom. Edna, thinking that male Covenant Big Harry Mazur is retiring today, which will bring an end of his reign of terror. Edna sits down at the boardroom table. Angulum Edna. Edna, thinking and reign will begin. I will prove myself as a better CEO than any man could ever be. Harry, I know that this is going my last day working at my family's company, but it is also a family company and tomorrow will be my retirement party. Edna, voice over, thinking, get on with it, you worthless male, so I can take over as reigning CEO. Harry, so without further ado, allow me to introduce the next CEO of Mazur Incorporated. Show that Edna had gotten up and is standing right next to Harry Mazur. Edna, interrupting Harry, so why don't you shut up and stop mansplaining, you worthless male pig? Because I've already accepted the position and I will be a better corporate president than you could ever be. The boardroom goes silent for a few seconds and then Harry and the board of directors instantly laugh at Edna. Elliot, laughing, hey Harry, you know how you have that retirement party later today? Harry, laughing, yes. Elliot, laughing, then maybe you should make Edna here your party clown. Harry, laughing, yeah, that would be a great idea. The laughter stops. Harry, so anyway, before I was so rudely interrupted. Edna steps backwards. William walks into the boardroom. Harry, allow me to introduce my son William Mazza, the next president of Mazza Incorporated. Edna surprised, but that's absurd. Max, I can't believe that you didn't know. He's been at the office every day for the past decade, and most of us have been molding him into the next CEO of this company, and I don't the big man here allowing you to steal his son's birthright. Bob, yeah, why do you think that he even had a reason to get married in the first place? Harry, thanks, Max, I couldn't have said it better myself. Josh, yeah, he's the king, he needed a queen, so that she could give birth to his successor, you know, to be the heir to the throne. Angle on Harry and William. Harry, I can't lie, everything he said was right on the money. William, the first have to agree running this company is my birthright. Edna screaming in anger, this absurd, I have been working for this company for the last 35 years of my life and I have worked harder than any of you, I should be the next CEO, not this snot-nosed woman objecting punk. Harry screaming in anger, Edna. I don't care what you've done for my company, you will not speak about my son like that, now walk up to him and apologize. The boardroom goes silent for a second. Harry screaming in anger, do it, you're fired. Edna livid and heartbroken, but sir. Harry screaming in anger, I said do it. Edna, I'm sorry. William to Edna, what's that, I think you forgot something? Edna, what did I forget? William sarcastically and condescending, oh, I don't know. Maybe a title that I'm going to have soon, one with that would have the word future in front of it. Edna pauses. Edna disappointed, I'm sorry, boss. Edna pauses again. Edna livid, I need to take a sick day. Edna screams and storms out of the boardroom. Elliot, we should probably consider this a sick day. INT New York Mazza Crop Office Cubicles Day. Edna enters the room. Edna thinking, I need something to eat. Edna walks by an empty cubicle with a sandwich in it that was made with Euro bread. Edna walks into the cubicle and steals the sandwich. INT New York Mazza Crop Hallway Day. Edna walks into the hallway. Edna thinking, how dare he? Edna walks through the hallway. Edna thinking, how dare that little brat mansplain me? Angle on Edna's mouth. Edna takes a bite out of the sandwich. Mazza Crop Elevator Day. Edna enters the elevator, while, as she finishes the sandwich, Harry voiceover, so without feather to do, allow me to introduce the next CEO of Mazza Incorporated, allow me to introduce my son William Mazza, the next president of Mazza Incorporated. Harry voiceover screaming in anger, Edna. I don't care what you've done for my company, you will not speak about my son like that, now walk up to him and apologize. William voiceover sarcastically and condescending, oh, I don't know. Maybe a title that I'm going to have soon, one with that would have the word future in front of it. Edna voiceover disappointed, I'm sorry, boss. Max laughing, I can't believe that you didn't know. He's been at the office every day for the past decade and most of us have been molding him into the next CEO of this company and I don't the big man here allowing you to steal his son's birthright. Elliot laughing, then maybe you should make Edna here your party clown. Harry laughing, yeah, that would be a great idea. Edna begins laughing insanely. EXT New York Mazza Crop Parking Lot Day. Edna gets into her car and drives off. INT New York Random Costume Day. A name store clerk, thank you for your purchase name. Edna laughing, oh, you're quite welcome. Cut to INT New York Edna's Apartment Day. Edna stands in her apartment wearing the court jester costume. Edna laughing. It's like Josh said, that male covenant big Harry Mazur, and today is the day of his party, and he'll be needing his court jester for that. INT New York Mazur Crop Boardroom Day. The guests of Harry Mazur's retirement party clink their glasses. William, okay, now please allow me to make a toast to a very important person, my dad, the man who without this company would most likely be in the toilet. Harry, I'm sorry to interrupt you, son, but does anyone smell smoke? The fire alarm is instantly triggered. EXT New York Mazur Crop Parking Lot Day. Show that Edna, wearing the jester costume, has set the building on fire. Angle on Edna. Edna laughing insanely, ha, 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 so tell King laugh at my fire prank. Edna begins to dance around. Edna laughing insanely, do you like it? Do you think it's funny? I sure do. Do you think I'm funny? Because I'm a goddamn joke. INT New York Mazur Crop Boardroom Day. Harry screaming in terror, quick, everyone evacuate the building. Harry, William, and the board of directors run out of the room. INT New York Mazur Crop Parking Lot Day. Edna giggles in the parking lot as the building right behind her is burnt down. Edna laughing insanely, teehee, I'm so funny. Edna looks forward and then sees security guards charging directly at her. Edna oppie she dubsy, I'd better run. Edna runs to her car, gets into it, and drives off. EXT New York City Streets Alleyway Day. Edna drives to the alleyway and gets out of her car. Edna to a figment of her imagination, wow, now that I pulled off that fire prank, I think that I should park here and run back to my apartment. Do you think I should lose the costume? A named cop voice over, hands in the air, clown. Cut to INT New York Courtroom Day. Show Edna hooked up to the Revelation 9000. Edna, and after that I was arrested and locked up in an insane asylum for over 3 months until I was able to find my way back to sanity. Now get removed the helmet off of my head. Charlie, Your Honor, as you can tell, Dark Hero Incorporated's main product is not safe. It's a poison. The Revelation 9000 showed that it turned one of my clients into a deranged arsonist who dresses like a medieval clown. Edna is released from the Revelation 9000. Matt, I object. None. Dark Hero Incorporated's products are by no means dangerous. In fact, their main product, Hero Bread, gave that one boy those both psychic and spiritual powers on the day that his school was struck by a school shooter, and he used those powers to stop him. Charlie, that's absurd. Anyone with enough balls would have just snuck up on that psycho, and the police would have arrested him. Matt, those cops would have never had a chance without that hero, as the shooter would have ended his life, they always do. Charlie, to prove my client's guilt, I call Gorham Steff to the stand. Gorham takes the stand. Charlie, Mr. Steff, isn't it true that it was Hero Bread that was the poison that put your father into a coma? Gorham, yes. Yes, it was. Show Diane in the jury box. Diane screaming, while pissed off, Hero Bread is the reason that my husband is in the hospital. Matt, well, isn't it also true that your father was the infamous hitman Elliot Steff? Gorham, well. Matt, well, you can either admit that your father was the man that the assassin Bradley Massey, who might add is currently in police custody, or you can have a seat in the Revelation 9000 and the information can be forced from your head. Gorham, okay, I'll admit Bradley Massey is my dad, and the man responsible for putting him into a coma is in police custody. Show Diane in the jury box. Diane screaming, While pissed off at percent and asterisk you hero Brett is a poison that nearly killed my husband. Judge Wallace Bailiff, please remove this woman from this courtroom. Two bailiffs grab a hold of Diane and drag her out of the courtroom. Charlie, okay, then I call Christy Routh to the stand. Judge Wallace, Ms. Routh, please take the stand. Matt to Judge Wallace, you honor, based on both the crime that this woman was dragged to the police for and that she was brought in by an actual superhero, I insist that we use the Revelation 9000 to get the truth. Judge Wallace, well, if she's not guilty, she will have nothing to hide. Christy is hooked up the Revelation 9000 and has the helmet on her head. Angle on the Revelation 9000 quote S massive TV screen. Cut to INT New York grocery store day. Christy Routh is grocery shopping, pushing the shopping cart. Show that Christy has a ton of TV dinners under the Lonely Woman brand. Catalan voiceover, well, if it isn't the Mad Hatter. Christy turns around and sees Catalan standing with her daughter Karen in the seat of her shopping cart. Christy, well, if it isn't a dummy slut. Angle on Christy's shopping cart. Catalan notices tons of Lonely Woman brand TV dinners in Christy's shopping cart. Catalan, based on the amount of Lonely Woman brand TV dinners is your cart, I can only assume that all of the things that you said about boys in high school was a mistake. Christy, I'm a career woman. Catalan, is your career rotting all alone, because my husband's the provider and I have been doing a bang-up job raising our kids. I provide for myself, I don't need a man. Catalan, well, I set a good example for my little Karen here, and I know that when I grow old I'm going to have lots of little grandchildren. So, if you're so smart, then let me ask you a question. Christy, there's nothing that a dumb bimbo could ask me that I can't answer. Catalan, when you grow old, who will be there for you? I will have my friends, my husband, my children, and someday my grandkids. Who will you have? Christy inconstantly pauses. Catalan, yet I didn't think so. Catalan looks directly at Christy. Catalan to Christy, unlike you, I'm happy where I am. Catalan to Karen in a baby talk tone, let's go, Karen. Karen, okay, mommy. Catalan walks off, pushing Karen in her shopping cart. Christy screaming at Catalan in anger, you don't know me. You know nothing about me. You hear me, you retarded cheerleading squad whore. Catalan continues, walks off, pushing Karen in her shopping cart, completely ignoring Christy. INT Christy's apartment kitchen night. Christy is making a sandwich. Christy, thinking I still can't stand that worthless baby maker, cheerleader slut. Show the bread near the sandwich that Christy is making is hero bread, as she finished making it. Christy takes a bite out of the sandwich. Christy, thinking, while chewing, I don't care that she has a child, they'll eventually abandon her, and that pig that she's married to will divorce her. When he has a midlife crisis, just he can go chasing after young innocent girls when he's an old creep. Christy takes another bite out of the sandwich. Carrie voiceover, Catalan Wilson was always a good for nothing slut. Christy, Miss Skank. Christy begins to hallucinate, seeing Carrie Skank, one of her old teachers from high school. Carrie voiceover, all of your life choices were the right ones. That little whore thinks that bows down to a man and become her slave, you will actually make you happy. Christy, yes, I know she thinks that that husband and those little brats of hers actually make her happy. Carrie voiceover, I was aware about that just by looking at her grades. Christy, I know she completely delusional. Carrie voiceover, I know what you should do about this little run-in with this old bully. Christy, what should I do? Carrie voiceover, well, in her insanity, she thinks that a worthless husband and unruly kids will make you happy. You do the opposite. Christy, and what is the opposite? Carrie voiceover, if you can take away the man that she leeches off of and remove her kids from the picture and force her to prove for herself, sure at first because of her wrong mindset, but if she provides for herself for long enough, she'll be very happy and eventually she'll act as her family never even existed. Christy, screaming, you're absolutely right. Cut to EXT Benjamin Franklin Elementary School parking lot day. Christy drives into the parking lot and gets out of her car. Show that Christy is wearing a lab coat making her look like mad scientist. Angle on Christy's face. Christy thinking, oh, I think that Professor Christy is going to teach these little brats a more important lesson than what they're learning right now. Blast Kinesis voiceover, all right, class is officially dismissed. Christy looks to find two children, a boy dressed as a superhero and a girl dressed as a genie. Blast Kinesis, you can back off if we can beat and we can drag you to the police. Carrie voiceover, these brats are as traditional as Kathleen Wilson and her bitch friends are. You have to kill them to make sure that other kids will turn out convective. Edna laughing insanely, Miss Skank, you're right, you're always right, I'll get rid of these rotten unliberal kids. Edna continues to laugh insanely. Blast Kinesis, I was hoping you'd say that. Angle on Blast Kinesis' face. An explosion occurs inside of Christy's body. Christy screaming in pain. Christy falls into the parking lot. Blast Kinesis, just to let you know who you're dealing with, the name's Blast Kinesis. My superpower is that I can make explosions happen with my mind, and my sidekick Pink Genie is great with using magic. Christy begins to get up off of the parking lot. Edna laughing insanely, you rotten little brat cannot stop me, because I'm fighting for the greater good. Christy completely to get up off of the parking lot. Pink Genie, you are not fighting for the greater good, we are. Edna screaming in anger, you, a slave, someone who has to obey any command that he gives, has the nerve to lecture me? Pink Genie, if a slave, when you are responsible for my enslavement. Edna screaming in anger, what? Pink Genie, Master and I were scared when you started pumping toxin into our school's water supply, when the principal evacuated us into the auditorium, and when we were exchanging snacks, my master gave me a magic sandwich and I was sucked into the water bottle that I gave him, turning me into a genie. Blast Kinesis, oh, just for the record, I had Pink Genie to use her magic to edit the memories of our classmates and teachers, so don't think that you can blackmail us. Edna, who do you little brats think that you're talking to? Pink Genie, a degenerate. Edna screaming in anger, I'm not a degenerate. I'm a modern independent woman. Blast Kinesis, I wish that this bitch was in a straight jacket. Pink Genie, very respectfully, as you wish, Master. Pink Genie claps her hands and Christy is suddenly wearing a straight jacket. Christy surprised, what the hell? Blast Kinesis, we are going to drag you to the police. A second explosion occurs inside of Christy's body. Christy screaming in pain. Blast Kinesis, I wish that all three of us were at police headquarters. Pink Genie, very respectfully, as you command. Christy, Blast Kinesis, and Pink Genie are teleported out of Benjamin Franklin Elementary School's parking lot. INT New York Police Department Day. Christy, Blast Kindness and Pink Genie appear inside of the New York Police Department. The police officers stare at Christy, Blast Kindness and Pink Genie in confusion. Angulum the confused police officers. Blast Kindness is to an unnamed cop. She tried to poison everyone in our school, Booker. A named cop up, okay. Cut to INT New York courtroom day. Show Christy hooked up to the Revelation 9000.